Welcome to Bellin's commencement ceremony for the BSN Fall graduating class. This is a day of celebration for our 28 graduates and their families and friends who supported them in their education to becoming a baccalaureate prepared nurse. It's a day of celebration for our faculty, staff, administration, and board of trustees. It's all about educating healthcare professionals for the future, as our college mission states. Today, you will be joining the many other graduates from our program who have found a rewarding career as a registered nurse. Bellin College has a 111-year history of educating healthcare professionals. The college is a special focus institution offering education in health sciences, which makes us very unique. The journey began in 1909 when the college was known as the Deaconess Sanitarium Training School for Nurses, where the three-year diploma began. In 1925, the school's name changed to Bellin Memorial Hospital School of Nursing when the hospital's name changed to Bellin Memorial Hospital in honor of its founder, Dr. Julius Bellin. In 1983, the Wisconsin Board of Nursing granted the school approval to begin a baccalaureate nursing program. With that change, the school's name changed to Bellin College of Nursing. In 2004, we began offering our first master's degree in nursing, and in 2009, we moved to our current location where we began offering a bachelor's program in radiologic sciences along with general education courses, and our name changed to Bellin College as we are known today. 111 years later, we have started several other programs to offer students in our communities. Here are some of them: a family nurse practitioner with post-master certificate options, an RN to BSN completion program in conjunction with Bellin Health, a bachelor's of science in sonography or ultrasound, a certificate program in diagnostic cardiac sonography or echo, an orthopedic manual physical therapy fellowship program, and a doctor of science in physical therapy, our first terminal degree. And this past August, we began a bachelor's degree in radiation therapy. As healthcare professionals, you are graduating from an educational program that provided you with a solid foundation for your career. The college is extremely proud of your accomplishments and your talents. Each of you have established a pathway for future graduates, and you have secured a degree that will provide you with a lifetime of opportunities in nursing, advanced practice, and leadership. Congratulations to each and every one of you, and to the faculty, staff, administration, and board of trustees who worked with you and supported you on your journey. Our quality and our reputation are built on generations of Bellin graduates who have transformed healthcare. And I know that each and every one of you will do the same. Our independent institution, Bellin College, is a part of Bellin Health Systems. Bellin Health is known for its high quality and cost-effective care, which serves a market of over 630,000 people in northeastern Wisconsin and the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. For over 100 years, Bellin's focus has been on improving the health and strengthen our communities that it serves for healthcare. As part of your graduation ceremony, you will hear a special message from Ms. Chris Wileski, President and CEO of Bellin Health. Ms. Wileski serves as a member of our Board of Trustees and is a steadfast supporter of Bellin College and our innovations. Please enjoy her message to each and every one of you.
As the President and CEO of Bellin Health, I would like to offer our congratulations to you on completing your degree. While I would prefer to be with you in person, I did not want to miss this opportunity to share with you how proud all of us at Bellin Health are of your accomplishments. Dedication, compassion, and commitment to serving the health and well-being of people and communities are the ever-important traits of healthcare professionals. You are joining a profession that is highly regarded And with that also comes much responsibility, especially during this pandemic. The public's trust in us as healthcare professionals requires that we role model the recommended precautions, even when out in public, by washing our hands frequently, not touching our face, wearing a mask, maintaining 6 feet of physical distance, and avoiding social gatherings where these precautions are not possible. Our patients need us to stay healthy so that we can be there for them when they need us. Take some time to celebrate your accomplishment and take note of how you feel so that you can come back to these feelings to reignite the dedication, compassion, and commitment to serve others throughout your career. Congratulations.
Mr. Mike Van Asten currently serves as our board chair. Mr. Van Asten is the owner and president of Incredible Edibles. He has a passion for business, management, and development. He supports the college's growth and has a strong desire to increase our philanthropy. Mr. Van Asten knows higher education, and his commitment to the success of the college is demonstrated through his leadership as our board chair. Mr. Van Asten will share a message with you as well.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of the 17 members of the Bellin College Board of Trustees, I'm honored to congratulate each and every graduate. This is the culmination of your achievements and of the physical, emotional, and financial investment higher education requires. The end of one journey, the beginning of the next. I assure you, each and every member of the board, each and every member of the college community, applaud your many accomplishments and wish you good health and great success as you continue to make a positive impact on our world. The abrupt turn of events since the beginning of the year has presented challenges unprecedented in our lifetimes. I want to thank and recognize Connie and the entire college leadership team for all they have done and all they continue to do to manage the unthinkable, earthquakes and aftershocks. It appears we have survived the earthquake. Now our challenge is to navigate the aftershocks, the unintended consequences of that initial shock to our global community. No doubt the statistics we hear day after day are sobering. And yet, even in the midst of a pandemic, it's important to celebrate. We've been forced to cancel the traditional celebrations, but we don't have to cancel celebrating. No virus can destroy your dreams and aspirations. This is a bump in the road, not the end of your journey. While the days ahead will undoubtedly present additional challenges, today represents a new beginning. Celebrate this moment. What matters after we celebrate today is what we do to define tomorrow, the future. There's no instruction manual for a time like this, but by working together, we will make our way to the other side of this crisis. You, the most recent graduates of Bellin College, will carry on, will make all of us proud. You are essential.
I would also like to thank all of our board members for their time and dedication to our mission and to our students. The college functions because of the faculty, staff, and administration who are extremely passionate about our students and their success. I would like to thank everyone at the college for their commitment to our students. Who would have ever thought that when 2020 began, we would be in the middle of the pandemic now in the month of October? That really doesn't seem to have an end in sight. I did not think we would be hosting a drive-by graduation for each and every one of you, but COVID has created us to do things very differently. You learned virtually, you came back to class, and you learned in a way that is going to make you a much stronger registered nurse. COVID-19 has left its mark on everyone, and it has changed your lives forever. Masking, social distancing, excellent hand hygiene, all of these are things that you would do as healthcare leaders. And I know that COVID is not going to slow you down. It showed me how resilient each and every one of you are, and how determined you are, and how you are going to deal successfully with change. You learned the importance of being flexible and going with the flow. Nurses are critical to the success of the slow of this pandemic. Did you realize that there are 4 million registered nurses in the United States fighting this pandemic today? That means there are 4 times as many nurses as physicians, 8 times as many nurses as pharmacists. Nurses also spend more time with the patients, their families, and support systems than any other member of that healthcare team. The ingenuity of nurses has contributed to the many new aspects of care, the new technologies, and the new work environments that we are providing healthcare in. Nurses continue to be innovators and can use their skills and their talents to transform healthcare. It would be extremely difficult for a healthcare organization to run without each and every one of you at the bedside providing care. You are the glue that keeps the patient and their care together. You learned how to critically think, and you use your critical judgment to help patients achieve their optimal health. You are innovative, you are creative, and you are compassionate. And you are at the heart and the soul of the healthcare organization's success. So I want to thank you now as you begin your nursing career, because I know you're going to create great change. Today you're going to begin that journey as a registered nurse. You will begin applying the knowledge, the skills, and the abilities that you have learned to provide outstanding nursing care. You will prioritize and you will take care of patients in a way that shows your compassion and your ability to nurture. People will respect you. They will look up to you. And they and the coworkers will be excited about the new and creative things you bring to the unit that you will be working on. The college values of excellence, integrity, community, and caring serve as the guiding principles as you provide quality and safe care. Your leadership attributes are evident, and you will excel in your role as a registered nurse. Be sure to thank your family and your friends for their support during your nursing education. I know it was not always easy for you. It's a very compressed program that requires you to work hard, and you persevered during the middle of a pandemic. As you depart from Bellin College as a graduate nurse, remember to keep excellence, integrity, community, and caring in your heart and soul. Know that you are a leader, and know that you will do amazing things throughout your nursing career. Your class motto says, "Nothing can stop us now, not even COVID-19. You are at the end of your journey, but you will start a new one when you leave us today, and you will leave a mark on nursing and healthcare forever. Congratulations and best of luck to the Fall BSN Nursing Graduating Class of 2020. The commencement address provides an opportunity to share wisdom and insight for your career as a professional nurse. Dr. Mary Roloff, Dean of Nursing at Bellin College, is our commencement speaker. Dr. Roloff has been with the college since 2003 and has held a variety of positions throughout her career with us. She earned her PhD in nursing education from the University of Northern Colorado. Her nursing background is neonatal nursing, and she is passionate about the tiniest patients in our profession. Dr. Roloff teaches both in the graduate and the undergraduate programs, and she loves curriculum and is always researching ways to improve how we educate our nursing students and create success. I am confident that Dr. Roloff will have an excellent message to share with you. Please enjoy listening to her commencement speech.
Graduates for October 2020. On behalf of the nursing department, I congratulate you on achieving your Bachelor's of Science in Nursing. You know that when you put the RN and BSN initials behind your name, they are earned, not given. You have worked for this degree, and we applaud you. I can't help but think back to your orientation just literally months ago. To be honest, I don't recall specifics, but I'm sure we talked about the rigor of a BSN degree, the challenges ahead, and ultimately the rewards inherent to a nursing career. All true, but so much more has happened since May of 2019. I don't think I knew in that May orientation that 2020 was to be declared the year of the nurse, celebrating Florence Nightingale's 200th birthday. Well, here we are. And the year of the nurse has taken on a meaning few could have imagined. Throughout the last 6 months, nurses have been referred to as superheroes and angels of mercy. Complimentary for sure, especially compared to the portrayals of nurses often seen in TV and movies. But I beg to differ. I've worked with a lot of nurses, and none of us wore capes or had extraordinary powers. Nurses are known for caring and compassion, but angels? I don't think so. What we have, what you have, is a specialized body of knowledge. You may have thought at the end of your first 8 weeks that there was nothing more you could fit in your brain. And then the next session came. Now you have successfully completed the program and can better appreciate the importance of lifelong learning. As we've navigated the twists and turns of the pandemic, we've realized how rapidly information changes, reinforcing the need for practice based on evidence rather than rumors or speculation. You have skills to carry out the procedures needed to provide best practices in safe and effective manners. And you have the values and ethical principles instilled in all nurses since the time of Nightingale. You are joining a profession that is committed to the inherent worth and value of every person. As such, we advocate for fair and equitable treatment for all. We advocate for the vulnerable, and we speak on behalf of those who aren't able. We believe in each person's right to make their own decisions, and we help to educate so their choices are informed. And of course, we do it within a code of ethics that makes nursing consistently ranked as the most trusted profession. Those values are reflected within the college values of excellence, caring, integrity, and community, values that you now own as part of your professional identity. You were nearing the end of session four when COVID first arrived in Wisconsin, just over halfway through the program. Of course, no one could have predicted what the path would take, just as we don't know what's around the next curve. But when the college transitioned all courses to online and clinical sites closed, you persevered. You stepped up, you adapted, and you pressed forward, just as nurses have done since Florence Nightingale. Throughout this experience, I've thought often about nurses during times of crisis and uncertainty. I think of the nurses in Crimea when nursing was in its infancy, during the Spanish flu of 1918. I think of the nurses who graduated in 1942, Like you, they entered their nursing program during a time of peace and calm in the United States, and they graduated into a world war. I think of those caring for patients stricken down with polio, healthy and running around 1 minute, collapsed and paralyzed the next. And I remember when AIDS didn't have a name, and when SARS and Ebola first appeared on our shores. And now, COVID. Throughout history, in times of crisis, nurses step up. They persevere, they innovate, and they lead. So no, I don't think we are superheroes or angels, but we are nurses, and that title carries so much more. You now join those ranks, and we all couldn't be prouder to claim you as alumni and as peers. Congratulations, BSN Class of October 2020. Your class motto states that nothing can stop you now, and I absolutely believe you. Stay safe and be well.
The BSN class speaker is Crystal Bauer. She wanted to be a nurse because of her desire to help patients and be a part of that healing process. She came to Bellin College because of her outstanding ability to prepare nurses in a holistic manner. After graduation, Crystal will be working at ThetaCare in their medical unit. Her dream job is to becoming a travel nurse. She is appreciative of the support she received from her family and is proud to have her mom, her brother, and her sister and their families celebrating with her today. Please enjoy hearing a special message from Crystal.
Good afternoon. My name is Crystal Bauer, and I want to welcome you to this unconventional graduation ceremony of the October 2020 cohort here at Bellin College. I stand before you all today witnessing my dream and many others finally coming true after a lot of sleepless nights, hard work, tears, frustrations, and exams. I chose to return and complete my BSN degree several years after completing my undergraduate degree in biology. I worked in healthcare for a while, and I always knew that's where I wanted to be, and nursing was definitely an interest I wanted to pursue. But, like so many others, I never thought making my dream come true was so tangible later on in life. Thanks to endless support from family and friends, I made the life-altering choice to join the 15-month accelerated BSN nursing program here at Bellin College, and to say that these last 15 months have been an experience would be an understatement. We all came together last May for that first week of classes with different backgrounds, knowledge, reasons for pursuing this dream, but we all did have one thing in common. We were gonna take this program head on together. The challenges began right away with a very first session. Trying to balance the intense workload we had per class, comprehending pharmacology, trying to find our sanity, and balance in life, along with getting to know one another, we soon became a family. We leaned on each other, we learned from one another, we shared laughs in class, tears after exams, and with each session, as things progressed and got harder, we grew closer. A quote I'd like to share that sums up our time together here at Bellin College is from the movie The League of Their Own. It's supposed to be hard. If it wasn't hard, everyone would do it. The hard is what makes it great. As a group, we have been through so very much together over this last year, including, like I said, so many exams, skills testing, which was so nerve-wracking, some heated debates, surgeries, illnesses, birthday celebrations, handling real patients, trying to figure out how to handle online patients, and returning to handling real patients, with some hesitation, of course. There isn't much we haven't been through as a group in this time together. From figuring out what nursing diagnoses are and how to use them to standing before you today, you name the situation, we as a cohort have gone through it. And so much more than any of us would have ever anticipated, both personally and professionally, while we went through this program. Because of all of these experiences, we are stronger, braver, somewhat wiser, and some of the most well-rounded nurses you will ever encounter. Would many of us want to take the traditional path of the 15-month program like so many before us? Of course, that's what we thought we all were doing. But looking back over these last 15 months and all we've been through, I don't think any of us could say it wasn't an adventure. To say we have had the most unique nursing school experience prior to any other 15-month program here at Bellin would be yet another understatement. It certainly wasn't easy most of the time, but it definitely has been worth it. We began this program like so many others before us, yet we stand here today having witnessed firsthand how one not-so-simple virus can affect us, not only changing our entire educational course, but also in our professional lives as we enter into a time very uncertain in the healthcare field. With all of this behind us, we look optimistically to our very bright futures as registered nurses, knowing we can face anything now. So cheers to all of you who have supported and cared for us during this crazy time of our lives. And cheers to you, my friends, my fellow nurses, and my new family, for giving it all you've got all the time to everyone in your life and to this program, all to make the world a better place. And in the famous words of one of her classmates and a wonderful actress, hoo, peace out.
Well, guess what? It is time to issue your diploma and to grant your degree. Will the candidates for the bachelor degree in nursing please stand? On the recommendation of the faculty of Bellin College and the action of the Board of Trustees, I now confer your degree as a Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and in testimony thereof, you will receive your diploma. As Mr. Matt Rentmeester calls your name, please join me under the tent to receive your diploma and your gift bag. Once you have received your diploma, please move your tassel to reflect your status as a graduate. Congratulations to each and every one of you. You have done it. You whipped through our curriculum, you were successful, and you are survivors during this COVID-19 pandemic. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Chad Dahl, Alumni Council Chair, Class of 2002, would like to share a few words with you as the newest members of our alum. Please enjoy Chad's message to each and every one of you.
Congratulations, graduates. As the Alumni Council Chairperson, and on behalf of Bellin College Alumni Association, we applaud you on reaching your important milestone. To quote Michael Josephson, take pride in how far you've come, have faith in how far you can go, and don't forget to enjoy the journey. After all your hard work and dedication, you've earned your Bellin College degree. As you now prepare to embark on the next phase of your career, know that it's not just you against the world. You are now more than 3,000 plus Bellin College alumni worldwide. I want to share with you a rite of passage which comes with academic achievement. The responsibility of all graduates have in preserving value and inspiring excellence in the Bellin College degree. Now that you begin your nursing career and utilize the skills learned throughout your college years and put them to the test. Life is full of adventures, and every passion opens a door to various opportunities. It is important to step back and marvel at all the events that made us what we are today. The small joys and distresses have been life-changing, and it's important to give yourself a pat on the back for coming this far. it's equally important to have faith in yourself to achieve even more success in the future. I'm here today to ask that you maintain your relationship with the alma mater and your fellow alumni. We encourage you to participate in the Alumni Association. As an active member, you'll be in the inner circle doing your part to make Bellin College even stronger. We ask three things of you. We want you to stay connected. As a graduate, you're automatically part of the Alumni Association, but we need your help in keeping us informed of changes in your life so we're able to serve you better and keep you up to date on campus developments, upcoming events, and news regarding your fellow alumni. We also want you to be informed by reading our alumni newsletters, following us on social media, and returning to campus often. By staying informed, you make a wonderful ambassador for the college, within your profession, and to prospective students. And finally, we want you to remain involved, whether it's participating in an alumni event, such as the Alumni Homecoming, or other social events throughout the year, or by joining the Alumni Council itself, to help us promote and strengthen the relationship between the college and its alumni. The Alumni Association welcomes you and congratulates you and looks forward to helping you maintain your relationship with Bellin College. Thank you and congratulations.
This is truly a day of celebration for all of us, the graduates, family, friends, and all of the members here at Bellin College. It is an honor and a privilege to welcome 28 new graduates into the profession of nursing, and we are very proud of each and every one of you. We are confident that you will have an exciting career as a registered nurse. Thank you for your commitment and your dedication to the profession of nursing. I hope you enjoyed this virtual ceremony and our drive-by graduation event. Please stay in touch with each and every one of us. We are proud of you and we want to hear from you and know what you are doing. And thank you to all of the family and friends for coming to our ceremony. Best wishes to each and every one of you. Thank you and best of luck. Goodbye.